Good evening and welcome to another burping video. I will also show you how to change coolant on this M54 engine. Let's start with racing and securely supporting the car. The next step is to remove the belly pan. It is held by a small battalion of Phillips screws. There are four on each side. Afterwards, the pan will fall off. Now unscrew the radiator cap, as this will help speed up the draining process. My radiator has been replaced in the past and has a plug that you need to twist and pull out. If you have the older type, you need to unscrew it. Now place the largest pan or basin that you have to drain the coolant. Still, be prepared for some spillage. The coolant in this car looks pretty clean. If it is very dark, you might want to consider flushing it with water a few times. Once the dribbling has stopped or down to minimal, put back the drain plug. We also need to drain the engine block, so follow me along this short trip to show you which bolt we need to undo now. It sits right here, marked with the letter U. To access it, I went underneath the engine. It takes a 13mm socket and some patience, since there's not much room for ratcheting. Place the pan somewhere underneath the screw. Position doesn't need to be very accurate, as most of the coolant will go everywhere else anyway. Once the bolt is loose, you can undo it by hand. While we let the rest of the coolant to drain, let's clean the drain bolt a bit and of course replace the gasket. If you succeed in getting the torque wrench in there, tighten the bolt to 25 Nm. Since I have a compressor, I will use the vacuum method to fill the coolant. The setup looks complicated, but after 2 hours of searching for the instructions, I was able to connect all the hoses in the right place. The compressed air flows through here and in the process also soaks all the air from the system. Some coolant may also be extracted, so be sure to have a bottle ready at the end of this hose. This valve should be open during this step. Once you've reached about 25 inches of mercury or more of vacuum, close this valve. Then wait a few minutes and monitor the pressure. If it holds, there are no leaks in the system and we can proceed. When this valve is opened, vacuum in the system will be filled with whatever comes through this hose, so make sure it is always submerged in coolant. Initially, however, there will be some air in this hose, so just open the valve a bit to let it fill with the fresh coolant, close it, and again vacuum the system of that air that was just introduced. So, let's create some vacuum, make sure it holds, and open that valve. This car takes 10.5 liters of coolant. I will use almost 50-50 mix with 5.5 liters of softened water and 5 cans of the Aral Extra Antifreeze, obviously approved by the BMW. This jug says distilled water on the label, but it's actually just demineralized according to the standards for use in batteries and cooling systems. When the vacuum reaches zero, the system should be full. Check the coolant level and add it if it is low, or start the bleeding procedure if it is too high. Now set the fan to the lowest setting with heating to the max temperature, but don't start the engine yet. There are two bead screws that you should open until the coolant stream is free of air. First, open this one next to the oil filter, and then this one by the filler cap. Now check again, and if necessary, add coolant. I'm using this easy fill funnel in this step, but it's very useful also in the process of adding coolant if you cannot use the vacuum method. Then start the engine and give it a few high revs, but don't run it for more than about half a minute. After yet another coolant level check, run the engine until it reaches the operating temperature, or even drive the car on roads where it is safe to stop at any time. Monitor the temperature gauge closely, and if it's all good, it should be steady in the middle.